Hi, I'm Surbhi. We are at DPS 2017, and as we come to the close of it, I would like to have the pleasure of talking to Amit Bansal, who is the brain behind this conference. Welcome, Amit. How are you feeling today?
I'm feeling great. This is such a wonderful experience yet again. And this conference is just not an event for us. This has been our brainchild, and we have worked so hard. In the first year, I remember when I did the opening address in SSGS 2015, I said that this is celebration time for us because we did Asia's first SQL conference and we were all celebrating. And of course, when something happens for the first time, there's always some skepticism that will this happen again? Will this happen again year after year? And we did a hat trick, so it's wonderful. I want to thank my entire team at eDominer Systems and Data Platform Geeks community members. It's a long list, so I'm not going to take any names, but very indebted to them because they put in all the hard work behind this event. An event of such a great scale and magnitude cannot be pulled off by just a few people. So a big army was behind it, including all the volunteers who dedicatedly gave 4 days to us. So, I mean, this experience and all the excitement and all the pleasure of hosting close to 1,000 attendees across 3 days with about 100 speakers, 350 companies participating, all our sponsors and exhibitors, Microsoft. I mean, this is beyond words. So that's all I have to say.
Excellent. So would you also like to talk about the reincarnation that has happened, that it was first SQL Server Geeks and now it is Data Platform Geeks? What is the difference?
So the of course, in first 2 years, this was SQL Server Geeks annual summit. And as we all know that Microsoft Data Platform has moved beyond just SQL Server and there are so many pieces to it now, we decided last year that we would change the branding a bit and we have Data Platform Geeks now, a new reincarnation of SQL Server Geeks, and likewise we have renamed the conference as Data Platform Summit 2017.
Okay, so with all the excitement around, people are really excited about DPS 2018. So is there anything that you would want to reveal at this point of time?
Oh, there's nothing to reveal. It's no secret that we will come back again next year. Of course, we are working on the dates to see what suits best in terms of the venue, talking to our speakers and sponsors, and of course, all our wonderful customers. So yeah, we'll come back soon.
Definitely. So one last thing that as a speaker, I would like to know from you that there has been a perpetual shift in the technology trends in recent times, like with new technologies coming up like big data and cloud, all that. So how do you recommend people to cope up with this drastic change, and what should they really be doing?
So I think companies are now focusing a lot on secondary and tertiary skills, which means an individual cannot just survive with expertise on a single technology. I mean, I myself used to be just working on SQL Server without absolutely no knowledge of any other product or technology, but then those times have changed. Every company is asking people to be multi-skilled. So today you need to work on SQL, you need to work on Azure, you need to work on cloud, and companies are expecting a lot in terms of multi-skilling. So skill enablement is very, very critical, and that's where our conference is so critical, I believe, for the IT community, because 3 days, single platform, one platform with so many speakers, we are covering about 30 different technologies, 80 different subjects. So a wonderful place to be multi-skilled and make all the necessary connections so that you could continue learning beyond even the conference.
Great, excellent. Thank you so much, Amit, for putting this together for us and for everyone around. And we really thank you, and we hope to see you again at DPS 2018. Thank you.
I would like to mention one more thing. So when it comes to thanking people, I would also like to thank my family. They have been a great support. So without their support, spending this amount of time and energy behind any initiative wouldn't have been possible. So thank you.
So that is one thing that I really appreciate about Amit. I have been attending his session since over 8 years now, and his family is something that he never forgets to mention about. Really appreciate that. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.